super key versus candidate key versus primary key. This is where a lot of students get confused, especially in the difference between the super key and the primary key. In this video, I will take a slightly different approach to clear the concept. Instead of super key, I will start with the primary key. Primary key. I am assuming that you already understand primary key. If not, then basically it's one or more attributes that are used to uniquely identify each record in the table. In this table, std id, that is student id, is the primary key. Super key. Now let's understand the concept of super key. It is a superset of a key which should be able to uniquely identify each record in the table, which means it is key plus other attributes. Okay, does the definition of the super key sound a lot like that of the primary key? Well, in that case, note the difference. Super key is key plus any other attribute or attributes from the table. In other words, it is all possible combinations of key with other attributes. For example, in this table here, combination of student ID, mobile number, email, name and country is a super key. Why is it a super key? Because if student ID can uniquely identify its record, then student ID plus other attributes, mobile number, email, name and country, can also identify its record uniquely. Similarly, mobile number plus country plus name is also a super key. Email plus name is also a super key. As we know, emails are unique. That is, no two persons can have the same email address. So, emails can uniquely identify each record. If email can, then obviously email plus name can also do that. And similarly, student ID plus mobile number can identify its record uniquely. And many more combinations are possible. I hope you got the idea here. Now, which one is not a super key then? Name plus country is not a super key. Why not? Because the combination of names and countries can't be unique. There could be many students whose names are Ram and are from Nepal. And obviously, name alone cannot be a super key. Names are not unique. Candidate key. Candidate key is the minimal super key. Minimal here means that we remove all the unnecessary attributes, that is, the attributes which do not help to identify each record uniquely. In this example here, the name has no role to play in uniquely identifying a record. Email, however, is unique. So, email can be a candidate key. Basically, the candidate key is key minus other attributes. To be more specific, other unnecessary attributes. And a more academic definition is the super key whose proper subset does not exist is a candidate key, which almost means the same thing. In this table here, student ID, mobile number and email are candidate keys because they are unique and they can identify each record uniquely, and which is not a candidate key. Student ID and name is not a candidate key because name is the extra attribute here. Similarly, student ID and email is not a candidate key, because only one of these attributes, either student ID or email, is enough. And same for mobile number and email. So now I hope you understood the concept of super key and candidate key. Now getting back to the primary key. So how do we finalize the primary key then? One of the keys from candidate keys is chosen to be a primary key. Which one to choose? That is the question. Well, the answer is that mostly depends on the database designer. In this case, you can either go for student ID or mobile number or email. Just choose whichever makes more sense to you. In this case, I will choose student ID, because this most probably won't change. You know, sometimes mobile numbers and email addresses, they change, but student ID is not likely to change. So I am choosing student ID. Thanks for watching WebTech Paradise. For more videos like this, please subscribe to the channel.